Welcome to the Basilica Parish of the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary. Today is the Feast of the Holy Trinity. The Gospel today tells us of God's great love for our world, a love we know in the sending of God's Son and the Spirit to reveal God's love to us. This celebration is for all of us, regardless of our age, orientation, race, whether we worship regularly or only when we can, whether we embrace the life of the Church or struggling to find God in the midst of it all. To spread this good news is the mission of the Church, and we open wide our doors to all who come here today. Our celebrant for this Mass is our pastor, Father Mike Vitrano. Let us lift our hearts in worship and praise as together we stand and join in singing our entrance hymn, Lord, I Lift Your Name on High. Once again, that's Lord, I Lift Your Name on High.
So glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, may the grace, the peace, the love of our Lord Jesus be with you always. Good morning, everyone. We have a young people's choir. Wow. My prayers are answered. And you know, this is important because now it answers the question of other young people like, I'm not going up there if I'm the only one. So if now you're thinking, oh, look, they look pretty cool. I'd sing with them. Well, go on over. No time like the present to join in. Thank you for singing with us. Today is Trinity Sunday, a day to think about our life as part of the life of God, being part of the family of God. God is our Father. We, like Jesus, being the voice of God in the world and the empowering of the Holy Spirit, the Trinity of persons that is our God. And as we come together today, we ask the healing and blessing of our God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us praise our God.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King,
are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father,
let us bow our heads in prayer. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of holiness, made known to your human family your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the truth, the true faith, we may acknowledge a trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity and powerful majesty. For this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Thus says the wisdom of God, the Lord possessed me, the beginning of his ways, the forerunner of his prodigies of long ago. From of old I was poured forth, at the first before the earth, when there were no depths I was brought forth, when there were no fountains or springs of water, before the mountains were settled into place, before the hills I was brought forth, while as yet the earth and fields were not made, nor the first clods of the world. When the Lord established the heavens, I was there. When he marked out the vault over the face of the deep, when he made firm the skies above, when he fixed fast the foundations of the earth, when he set for the sea its limit, so that the waters should not transgress his command. Then I was beside him in his craftsmen, and I was his delight day by day, playing before him all the while, playing on the surface of his earth, and I found delight in the human race. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Fashion the earth and
sky, who created the deep, who exalts the lowly and sets captives free, who opens the door to all those who seek. Taste and see, oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of God. Taste and see, oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of God. Oh, the love of God, become flesh of our flesh, so that we might live in glory. Taste and see, oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of God. Taste and see, oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of the glory of God. Not only that, but we even boast of our afflictions, knowing that affliction produces endurance, and endurance, proven character. And proven character, hope, and hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit and life, you have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
My friends, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me because he will take from me what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. And for this reason, I told you that he will take from what is mine and give it to you." The gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Christ. So today is the feast of the Holy Trinity, the Trinity being that understanding, that teaching of our church, that our God, our one God, is actually three, Father, Son, and Spirit. And that in itself is kind of a eternal puzzle, right? How are we still the believers in one God when we have the Father and the Son and the Spirit? And so there, this threeness is somehow really a unity. And when you try to learn about that, it can lead to a lot of complexity. It's said that St. Patrick taught about the Trinity and its unity by showing people a shamrock. You see, there's three leaves, and they're all the same size, and they're all the same color, and yet it's one plant. And I'm always thinking that when he was using the shamrock that way, did he ever have any, like, kids like me there who would say, like, yeah, well, what about the four-leaf ones, huh? What about that? What about the four-leaf clover? Blessed if he didn't. Things were not much better in the seminary. There we really got into the philosophy, because this was sort of then a philosophical puzzle for believers. How is it that we talk about three and one as being the same thing and learn some fancy Greek language like consubstantial and homoousios and circumincession to describe the philosophical truth of the three and one? It really was one of those classes that you think, like, I just want to survive this. I just want to, you know, get a C and get out of here. And the saying among the seminarians were, we learned that there's five real relations, four processions, three persons, two natures, one God, and I still don't get it. Complicated. But one thing I do remember from that class is that great theologian in the church, Karl Rahner, said that just go back to what we experienced, what our people experienced in their relationship with God, and it all kind of unfolds there. And the Feast of the Trinity is here at the end of the Easter season and the beginning of the ordinary time of the year as a way of connecting the coming of Jesus into the world, his life, his death, his resurrection, and the sending of the Spirit into one experience. We're talking about that a little bit last week. So when you think of how the disciples came to their own awareness of who God was for them, what their relationship to God was like, well, it began with what they knew from their youth and what they had grown up with. Remember that they are Jewish. And so in Judaism, there is only one God. And not only is there only one God, but this God is above us, and really, you cannot speak God's name. You can only say things like Holy One, but there is no name of God. Moses up on the mountain asks God what his name is, and God says to him, I am who am, which someone commented is really a Jewish way of saying, mind your own business. I am God and you are human. You don't have to know more than that I am God. And in that awareness of God, they come to understand that Jesus now is talking to them about God and expressing the life of God to them. And they think of him as a prophet, because there can only be one God, and this God is above them. You can't see God. There is no image of God. There's no name of God. And yet Jesus is with them. And over time, they come to realize that he is not only the Son of God in the way that we might say we're all children of God, but he is actually the Son of God, the incarnation. And so we go in a way from God being above us to God being with us. And then after his dying and rising and those experiences of his resurrection, they come to the experience that this power of Jesus that he was using with them in teaching and preaching and healing is in them. And so they are not only talking about Jesus, they are talking about Jesus, but they're bringing that present experience from within themselves to the people that they are going out and being with. And this comes down generation to generation to generation. And so when we read in the Gospel of John, the newest of the Gospels, the one longest written after Jesus' life, they are talking about how they came to be aware that they were indeed sent the presence of God within, the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, who is now empowering everything that they do. God above, God with us, God within. And yet it's not just a kind of a fact about Jesus, but it's also a part of our own spiritual life. God is above us. And one of the things that's really important is that we understand that we are human and God is not within our ability to comprehend totally. We are not the authors of the universe. It was not our decision to create life this way. We're not the authors of everything, of life and death and the mystery of life and its power. And it's really a good thing for us as human beings to understand how to live with mystery in life. Sometimes when you talk to people, it sounds like, well, if I can't understand everything, then I'm not going to go with that. There's a lot of things that we don't understand everything about, including ourselves and other people and this world and the universe that we're part of. And the God above us is a way of understanding that or acknowledging that the mystery of God is beyond our understanding. And God is also with us. And I don't just mean, well, Jesus was with us for a while, but no, God is with us in the actions and in the lives of the people who believe in God, in Jesus, and in the Spirit. That's why the actions of the church are so important. We talk about the corporal works of mercy, the spiritual works of mercy, to heal, to help, to comfort, to feed hungry, to clothe naked, to help people who are struggling, to welcome strangers. Because through us, that is how God is with others. And it's because of others that I understand, through the love of others and the care of others, that God is with me. And the power of the Spirit is understanding something about our relationship to our own selves. That our, as St. Augustine said, our very hearts, our being, our person is made for something more. And we're not at rest, we're not at peace until we discover something of this relationship to God, and that the presence of God is within, and that it's something that's within us that we have and we can give to others. And in fact, that's the whole meaning of life itself, to give that. Jesus says to his disciples, if you hold on to what's within, you lose it. But if you give your life, your interior, yourself, away to others, then that is something you keep for eternity. That goes on forever and ever and ever. And that's not just sort of a moral command, like don't do the one, hold on, do the other. It's really Jesus saying to his disciples, that's how things are. You are meant to recognize God within and to be able to give that to others, to let it be free, and especially to acknowledge it as the mystery of your own self. You know, it's interesting. You can always tell how people were educated about their faith. Sometimes you'll ask young people, where's God? And they go, oh, God is above. God is far away. God's in the sky. And sometimes they'll say, oh, God's over there. God's in churches, God's in holy people, God's far away, God's over there. Sometimes you'll ask, where is God? And sometimes you'll say, God is here. God is in my heart, God is within me. In a way, what the Feast of the Trinity really says to us is that all are true at the same time. That's it, that's the whole thing. Go read the book if you want, all the theology and all, but that's the whole thing, that all three are true at the same time, that God is beyond our understanding, but right here with us, and right within us to be given to others in that kind of presence, which is the whole mission of the church and what it's about. Trinity is not a mystery to confuse us. It's a description of life and how it is. Part of life is a mystery beyond our understanding. So is God. It's part of the goodness of God. There is more for us than we can ask for or imagine, says St. Paul. God is in the simplicity of presence to another, a word, a gesture, forgiveness, healing, touch. And God is within and meant to be acknowledged as the center of our very life. Not really that complicated. Maybe it's just all too simple. Above us, with us, within us. Stand together now, we profess the faith that we share. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, who suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Brothers and sisters, on this feast of the Holy Trinity, we're mindful that God created us in love to live in harmony with God and with one another. And now on this day, we bring our prayers before the presence of God.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For peace among and within religions of our world, for respect for the faith of others, for those who lead us in our church, for those who serve and minister in the name of Christ, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For peace among nations, for an appreciation of our world, our one human family, for our unity in the one God who created us all, for an end to war, for the people of Ukraine, for the safe return of all military service women and men, for the victims of terrorism, for their families and loved ones, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who cannot be with us today, for the sick, the elderly, those who must work at this time, and all who may feel isolated from the community, for the names and needs in our parish bulletin and book of intentions, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, especially Tony Zorko and Justin Guglia, may they be given the joy and peace of the heavenly kingdom. And for those who mourn the loss of a loved one, for those who seek peace and consolation in their grief, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. At this Mass, we pray especially for the people of the parish, Emeritus P. Joyce, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we bring all of our prayers before you today. We pray them in the name of Jesus and the power of the Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
As we bring our gifts to the table of the Lord, let us join our voices in singing, We Come to Your Feast, which can be found in your music program. Again, that's We Come to Your Feast.
We place upon your table our gleaming cloth of white, the weaving of our stories, the fabric of our lives, the dreams of those before us, the ancient hope for Christ, the promise of a future, our needing and our nurture, a year before our eyes. We come to your feast, we come to your feast.
sits upon your table, a humble loaf of bread, the gift of field and hillside, the grain by which we're fed. We come to taste the presence of Him on whom we feed. You strengthen and connect us, you challenge and correct us, in love and world and deed. We come to your feast, we come to your feast. The young and the old, the frightened and the bold, the greatest and the least. We come to your feast, we come to your feast. The fruit of our lands and the work of our hands, we come to your feast.
May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord, our God, this offering of our service, and by it make us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in a single unity of a person, but a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and the Holy Spirit, so that in confessing the one true eternal Godhead, we might be adored, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity of substance, their equality and majesty. And so with all of creation, we praise you as we sing. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new, the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
We pray together now for the building of God's kingdom in the words Jesus taught us to pray each day. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. May the peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
To each other we extend the sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Please join in singing today's communion hymn, "Jesus, You Are Bread for Us."
Christ.
Next Sunday, June 19th, we will honor all of our 2022 graduates at our 9:30 Mass. Please be sure to invite all of our graduates to join us that day. Our annual Angel Tea will be held this Sunday, 2 p.m. at the OLH Auditorium. Please see the bulletin for more information about the event and to make reservations. Summer concerts on the Great Lawn return to Sacred Hearts this summer. Our first event will be on Tuesday, June 28th, as we welcome the Darren Otati Quartet in concert, performing songs from Broadway and the American Songbook. West Side Story, Jersey Boys, Kiss Me Kate, and Carousel are just a few of the shows that will be featured, along with many Gershwin and Cole Porter standards. So grab your picnic blanket or lawn chair and plan to be with us. Concerts begin at 6:30 p.m. Summer Sunday hospitality will begin July 3rd. Please contact the parish office if you or your group would like to volunteer to host one or more Sundays. Super raffle tickets are now on sale after each Mass or during the week at the parish office. Only 500 tickets will be sold. Each ticket is $100. Thank you for praying together with us today. Each week, our bulletin is full of upcoming events and activities happening here at Sacred Hearts. Please take home a copy of the bulletin today, for there are so many wonderful upcoming events here at Sacred Hearts.
Oh, I love those summer announcements. So many things happening, you know? And the Angel Tea is back after a couple of years shut down, and they're going to actually be holding their event over at Our Lady of the Hamptons today, the school over there. Still some tickets available, and there's a number in the bulletin if you want to give a call and go over to that, a great event with a great speaker today. And summer on the Great Lawn is back. Lots of music to come this summer. One of the most fun things that we do, just come and bring a picnic, a blanket, a lawn chair, and just enjoy the great sounds. And you know what's nice this summer is, last year we managed to fix up the a few things in the auditorium, like the air conditioning, so now we can be rain or shine. So if it's even a crummy night, we'll still go on with our concert and just move indoors. And speaking of fixing things up, I hope you enjoyed and noticed our plantings that got done this week outside of our basilica, looking particularly nice this week. And we also started work on, a lot of people tell me, oh boy, that big window needs painting. Well, it turns out after we got the scaffold up, started to do the painting, that big handfuls of rotten wood were coming out. So the painters managed to stabilize it with a little brace work, but now we have to get a look at how to restore that window for the years to come. Another basilica adventure. Ka-ching, ka-ching. we'll see what happens. I think it may not be too bad, but it definitely is good we found it. It's one of those things that has to get done. But the best news, of course, our new people participating this week are young people in the choir. You did so good, right? And a new lector today, Andrew. You did a wonderful job reading for the first time. It's nice reading up there, right? You never want to come down. It's a great view. Let's pray and give God thanks. May the receiving of this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is with you. May God bless us now and always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We go in peace to love and to serve our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks for praying for us today. Thanks to all who joined us online this morning. And go forth and have a great day, everyone.
You too, Father.
Our sending forth hymn this morning can be found in your music program. Please stay and sing with us, Blessed Be the Lord. Once again, that's Blessed Be the Lord.
Shadow of